Hello everybody, my name is Holly Devereaux and I'm an e-learning instructional designer for the Community Colleges of Spokane. And today we're going to be talking about how to access your OneDrive through your Office 365 online. The simplest way for us to do this is to go out to our homepage for Community Colleges of Spokane, either at Spokane Community College homepage or Spokane Falls Community College homepage. We're going to go over to the right and we're going to select Student Tools. This will bring up a drop-down menu where we can find Office 365. Go ahead and select that. This will redirect us to our organization's sign-in page. Go ahead and put your email address in there with your Bigfoot email. Going to give you a message saying that it's taking you to the organization's logon screen. This page should come up for you and you may have to enter your password in there. I've signed in on mine before, so mine is already saved in there. You're going to go ahead and you're going to click sign in. This will bring up another page with a dialog box that's asking you if you'd like to stay signed in. One suggestion I have for you, if this is your own personal device and it's not shared with anyone else and you have no privacy concerns, go ahead and select yes and this will keep you signed in. If this is a device that's shared with others and you have privacy concerns, go ahead and select no at this time. This is going to take you to the Microsoft Office homepage where you'll see many icons. You'll see the Outlook, OneDrive, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote icons, and so forth. For this video, we're going to go ahead and we're going to select the OneDrive icon and click on it. It may take a moment for your page to load, so be patient. Once your page has populated, you will see your files that have been loaded into OneDrive. If you don't have any files there because you've never used OneDrive before, that's okay. Up at the top, you'll see where you can add a new file, upload a file, and also sync. We'll talk about syncing later on. Over here, you'll also see files, recent, shared, and discover. We'll also talk about these options in a later video. That's it for today. Thanks and have a great day.